I'm Rowan from Vantage Admissions, and in this video we're going to explore the changes in TMUA scoring since the exam was taken over by UAT UK and Pearson VUE in 2024. From the pilot year of 2016 through to 2023, the TMUA was run by Cambridge Assessment, which closed down in 2023. From 2024 onwards, the administration has been handled by UAT UK in collaboration with Pearson VUE, and so there have been some changes to the logistics of the exam. In particular, whereas the exam was previously taken in school or an ordinary exam centre, from 2024 students register online and take the test at a Pearson VUE test centre, where you use a computer to input your answers to the multiple choice problems. Students are given an erasable notebook to use for their written workings. Students now have a choice of different time slots over 4 days in October and January, with 2 days in October and 2 days in January. As a result of the spreading of the TMUA across different days, the system of scoring and scaling has changed to ensure that all candidates can have their scores compared, even if they take the test on different days and therefore will have been served many different questions. This wasn't announced clearly before the first results came in for the October test, which led to a great deal of confusion and misconception among candidates. In particular, scaled scores were often much lower than expected, giving rise to the perception that the TMUA had become harder under UAT UK. In reality, while the scale has shifted, university requirements have also shifted to reflect this. So in reality, there is no substantial difference in the difficulty. The main difference to be aware of is that the questions are now likely to be more randomised in order. So whereas on the previous exams, you could be confident that the easier questions would appear at the beginning and the very hardest at the end, there will now be a mixture of difficulties throughout the paper. This makes time management more important than ever. Before 2024, TMUA candidates were given 3 scores, scaled from 1.0 to 9.0. They'd receive 1 score for each of Paper 1 and Paper 2, as well as a combined score reflecting both papers. The raw scores, out of 20 for each paper, were converted to scaled scores to reflect the variations in difficulty between different years of the exam. The scaled scores give an objective measure by which candidates could be compared to the typical performance of other candidates within their cohort. Using data collected from Freedom of Information requests, in particular for the scores obtained in 2022 and 2023, we've created this graph to show the pre-2024 distribution of scores. Roughly speaking, you can see that 75% of candidates would achieve a score of 3.5 or higher. 50% of candidates would score around 5.0 or higher. 25% of candidates would score 6.5 or higher. And to land in the top 10%, you'd need to be scoring around 7.2 or higher. Generally speaking, target scores for top universities would vary between 5.5 and 6.5 on this old scaling. From 2024, students now receive a single scaled score from 1.0 to 9.0, reflecting their performance across the two papers. This makes it easier for UAT UK to compare the performance of candidates who took different versions of the test, for example, on different days. The scaling curve has changed so that now an average candidate will receive a lower scaled score. But rest assured, the TMUA thresholds set by universities have also shifted to reflect this change. According to the officially provided explanation of results from UAT UK, for the October 24 and January 25 sittings, a typical candidate will have achieved a scaled score around 4.5, with around 10% of candidates achieving a score of 7.0 or higher. This graph was produced using data from the October and January sittings, depicting the distribution of scaled scores. A separate graph was also released using October data only. You'll notice that the combined graph is skewed more heavily towards the lower end, and this led to some misconception that the January exam was harder. In fact, there is a simpler explanation. Applicants to Cambridge were required to take the October sitting, and so many of the strongest candidates will have been removed from the January test pool. Using this data, we can also compare the 24-25 scaled scores to the distribution across earlier years. The new curve depicts the scores for the October 24, January 25 sittings combined. And just from a glance, it's very obvious that the distribution has changed substantially. From this graph, we can read off certain key benchmarks. For example, for these sittings, 75% of candidates scored higher than 2.7, around 50% of candidates scored higher than 4.0, around 25% of candidates scored higher than 5.0, and around 10% of candidates scored higher than 6.5. Note that these benchmarks are slightly lower than those which had been indicated by UAT UK, with the average being around 4.0 rather than 4.5, and the 10% cutoff being around 6.5 rather than 7.0. This is presumably because the scale was calibrated using the October data and then pulled down by the typically slightly lower scores achieved by the January cohort. Note that the upper end of the scale is very similar, with around 5% of candidates scoring 7.5 or higher on both the old and the new scale. The main difference is far greater resolution towards the upper middle end of scores. So what does all this mean in practice for a student taking the new TMUA? Ultimately, not a lot. You'll still be aiming to do the best you can to get the largest number of correct answers within the time available to you. You simply need to be aware that your scaled score on the real thing will likely be lower than the scaled scores you'll be achieving on the older pre-2024 past papers. When using older past papers, it can be helpful to convert the scores over so that you can track your progress and compare the level you're working at to your target on the new scale. Using the answer keys available on our TMUA resources page, linked in the description, you can easily convert your raw scores on pre-2024 papers to scaled 1.0 to 9.0 scores. It's then very straightforward to use the graph to map this to the equivalent score on the new scale. In particular, go along the x-axis to your achieved score on the older paper, and then run up to the old score curve. From here, run along to the new score curve, and then back down to the x-axis to read off the roughly equivalent score on the new scale. This should all be taken as an approximate guide. It's entirely possible that UAT UK may make changes to the scale again in the future, but this is what we know for now. I hope you found this exploration of the TMUA scaled scores helpful. If you're interested in more TMUA content, including advice on past papers, exam technique, and a range of exciting maths content, do remember to subscribe. And thanks for watching.